Hi, I'm Elle from eSpares, and in this video I'm going to show you how to test the selector switch on your oven using a multimeter. So if you find that your oven isn't heating, this could be due to the selector switch, but it could also be the thermostat or the oven element. However, in this video we are just going to focus on the selector switch. Bear in mind that the process can differ slightly between different makes and models, but on your oven the process should be similar to what we're going to show you. For this process, you'll need a flat blade screwdriver, a Phillips head screwdriver, a T20 Torx screwdriver, and of course, the multimeter. Not everyone is familiar with multimeters, so let's take a quick look at how they work. A multimeter is a testing tool, and it can be used to measure current, resistance, and voltage. And one of the uses of a multimeter is to test parts within appliances to see whether or not they're faulty. So before you start any work, it's important to disconnect the power from the appliance. So either switch off and unplug the machine, or if it's wired in, just flick the switch in the kitchen that powers the cooker, and also go to the fuse box and flick the switch there that powers the cooker as well to be extra safe. First up, you'll need to grab your Torx head screwdriver and just unscrew these two screws at the back here. So back to the front of the appliance, we now need to remove all of these control knobs and buttons. So to help you, if you grab your flat blade screwdriver and just use it to lever off each one. Now if we open the grill door, and we need to remove the two screws under the control panel here and here. So if you just grab your Phillips head screwdriver, and then you can unscrew them. Now that those screws are removed, we can take off the control panel by just shifting it slightly across and lifting it away. Then we grab our Phillips screwdriver again, and we just want to unscrew the screws at the top here. With the control panel removed, we can lift the top panel away and just flip it over to access the wires. Then we can unclip these clips here. One, and also this one, which allows us to fully remove the top panel. At this point, we're ready to set up our multimeter. So grab your probes and just make sure the black one connects to black and red connects to red here. Then switch it to the continuity setting. And lastly, turn it on. So with the top panel removed, we can see the selector switch here, but first we need to get the thermostat here out of the way. So if you grab your flat blade screwdriver again, just pop it down in between the groove and twist to remove the thermostat. And we can now have easier access on this side. But we do also need the Phillips head screwdriver to unscrew the two screws on this side, one fully and one partially, just so we can remove the selector switch to access it more easily. So with the selector switch removed, we can now disconnect these connections here. Do just take note of which side each colour connects to so that you can put it back together the right way round. So if we remove these, and then we're ready to go ahead and test. So what you want to do now is grab the control knob and just pop it back on the spindle. And if you turn it over, you'll see as you turn the control knob, these fins here go up and down. So we're going to test first in the off position. bring it back round. And what we want to do is put our T probes on the middle T here and just test. There's no sound, which is what we expected. But if we turn it to the on position and test again, we get a beep. That beep indicates that this part is actually working fine. So if you don't have a beep, that means the part is faulty and will need to be replaced. If you find when testing your selector switch that it is faulty, it will of course need to be replaced. But you do need to make sure you get the right replacement part to fit your model. So to help you, you can see our other video up here on how to find the model number for your oven, which will show you how to find the correct model information to get the right replacement part for your machine. So to fit your selector switch, let's connect the electrical connections first of all. Just pop it back through, line up the screw, and then just pop the second screw into place. Just tighten that one up as well. Next, you can grab your thermostat and just slide it back into place. Now you're ready to reassemble your machine. So first things first, grab the top panel again. Just gently lay it down so that we can reconnect these electrical connections. With these electrical connections connected, we can lift up the top panel and then just turn it over and then reposition it back. Now we can screw in the two screws here and here to secure the top panel. Now you can reconnect the lamps. And then just go ahead and reposition the control panel. Open up the grill, and then you can access those two screws you moved earlier at the bottom here. Just put them back in. Now we can refit all of our knobs and buttons. Just obviously make sure with the markings on the knobs, you're putting them back in the place that they were before. And then the buttons just be put back in as well. The final step is to replace the T screws to fully secure the top panel. And there you have it, how to test and replace the selector switch using a multimeter. If, when you were testing your selector switch, it was absolutely fine and didn't need to be replaced, as previously mentioned, the fault could also be down to the thermostat and very commonly the oven element. So check out our video down below on how to test the oven element, which also shows you how to replace it. Before you go, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for videos on diagnosis, repairs, and maintenance for all of your household appliances. Thanks for watching.